give me trouble now.
Just an insect. I'm sure you'll survive. Besides, it...
Lads, for the love of all that is holy, I've never clapped eyes on your poor sister.
Drop the act, hag. You was the last to see me, Rena.
Just let her go. Please.
You there! Please, I don't know what's come over these boys. I just want to go home.
Stop this! We won't ask again!
Careful! Don't trust a word out of her mouth. Our sister went to the hag, and we ain't seen her since.
Hand over heart, I don't know their sister. I will gladly help you all look for her, though.
Enough! Where is she?
Supposed to rush to my defense, love. Fat lot of good you are. Some advice? You ever darken my door, you'd best have that head bowed and an apology at the ready. Bye-bye now.
Chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. The place has a quiet sense of calm.
have my attention.
Oh. Soldier.
Can't give up now.
What's cooking?
Time to rest.
Again.
Just be on my way.
work. Try something else.
Must be the tree from the note to Korga. What's that cleft there? Nothing.
Why are you here? I sent you to Zevlor. What? That damn nose of yours has gone poking in our business.
Mistress Ollerton, I can explain.
Shh, shh. No need. It couldn't be helped.
Quagga, what is the meaning of this?
You think yourself quite the spy, don't you? Go on, tell him.
A shadow druid? Quagga, have you lost your mind?
You and Alsin welcome untouchables to your midst. You defile the grove for the sake of harmony.
Ollerton speaks truth. Who among you disagrees? Who would see this grove in ruin?
The choice is made. Quagga, burn the tainted away. Start with a snitch.
As you say, Ollerton. It trembles in shame. It knows that in harmony we perish. In shadow, we are pure.
Quagga's voice breaks and her lips tremble. She heard reason in your words. Quagga eyes you intently as you speak the text etched into the frescoes. By claw and tooth, from root to thorn, the old oak's grove to wildlings sworn. In darkest hour, a concord made, twixt harp and wild, against the shade.
When the darkest hour fell, it was us that brought light. Sylvanas demands we illuminate shadow, not hide within it.
How was I so blind?
Careful, Quagga. The shadows don't forgive.
I belong to the shadows no longer. You've no power over me.
You would question my power. Mother Earth, hear me. Grant me your wrath.
setting up. Watch this!
You once called me a monster. Seems I've proven you right. Sylvanas bid me to protect my people from harm. Yet I was the one to inflict it. There was but one druid who guarded the circle, who protected our ways. We are forever in your debt. You burn like fire. You howl like wind. You are Faith Warden. Take our gift and be known. May I not be the last monster you vanquish. It was through power that I would keep us safe. Or so I thought. Yet I betrayed Sylvanas himself, led the circle to Shadow. We will stop the rite, and I will stand trial. My fate lies with Sylvanas. May he have mercy. We will grant them safe harbor until they depart. Meanwhile, help us contend with the goblins. Perhaps we can dissuade them from attacking. It began with a letter. There was no messenger, it simply appeared. Olidan came soon after. An army was coming, she said. Goblins, drow, and more still. Legions upon legions. The druids of Cloakwood knew the dangers this would bring. They ordained that all circles cast the rite to shelter from the storm. Olidan taught me to harness the Tree Father's power to wall us in. In return, well, you know the rest. I would turn the grove over to... I won't forget the wounds I've inflicted.
They'll have to cut through all the tieflings first.
You will face Sylvanas' justice.
If it's an argument you seek, you won't find it here. Whatever the Tree Father's judgment, I will accept it in full.
And if the goblins get in here, what will happen to the grove? To us?
We almost finished the ritual. I felt honored when I was chosen to participate. Now I feel guilty I didn't object.
You're a common growth spell, but altered somehow.
Why, that's not at all foreboding.
Hold out your hand, mister. Go on. Take this ring. It's lucky.
Ask you one more time, boy. Hand over my locket.
I don't have your ugly locket. I never seen it before.
Hand it over or I'll slap the teeth out of your head. You threatening me?
You don't understand. The kid stole my locket. He... Oh, the hell's with this. These little devils get away with everything because of coddling bastards like you.
You'll get yours someday. I hope I get to see it.
Maybe you will, but personally, I doubt it. See you around.
I'm told the druids have stopped their damn chanting. What happened? Truly, Ilmater's ashes. I never thought she would actually see reason.
Thank you. We still have the goblins to contend with, but you've given us time to prepare. I need to ensure my people make the most of it. But here, left over from my soldiering days, it's sparse thanks for what you've done for us, but gods and goblins willing, I won't need it again. If you can clear the road of goblins, as you say, I'll ensure a reward is gathered for you.
Good to be alive.
I've got a long road ahead.
Need anything else? Always happy to help those who follow the first circle.
Sylvan.
Whatever comes, I'm ready.
All right, what now?
I'm ready, whatever it takes.
Quite ready for you.
Let's march!
Still breathing, despite everything.
Let's get on with it.
Condition likes being ignored as little as I do. I must consume another artifact. And soon.
Thank you.
Listen, I need to speak to you, to all of you. It would be unconscionable of me to remain silent. Just be about to remedy that. You have to know who I was. You have to know who I really am. What I am is a walking shadow of the promise I once held. I'm what one might call a wizard prodigy, who from an early age could not only control the weave, but compose it, much like a musician or a poet. Such was my skill that it earned me the attention of the Mother of Magic herself, the Lady of Mysteries. The goddess Mystra. She revealed herself to me and she became my teacher. In time, she became my muse. And later, even my lover. Oh, yes. We enjoyed each other's company. Body, mind, and soul. But even so, I desired more. You see, no matter how powerful a wizard we mortals can become, we never scratch more than the surface of the weave. Mystra keeps us in check. There are boundaries she doesn't let us cross, yet every time I was with her, I stood on the precipice, gazing into the wonders that lay beyond. I sought to cross her boundaries. I pouted, I pleaded, swore my ambition was only to serve her better. She only smiled and told me to be contented. Inconceivable as it seems to me now, I shared a bed with a goddess, and yet I wasn't satisfied. So I sought to prove myself worthy to her instead. We come now to the crux of my folly. Shall I share the story behind it, or would you rather head straight to its sordid finale? Suffice it to say, I obtained an obscure and ancient book
that had locked away inside a much coveted prize.
It was a fragment of primal weave locked out of time, locked away from Mistra herself. What if, I thought, what if, after all this time, I could return this lost part of herself to the goddess? I was certain that this deed of raw power, draped in romance, would convince Mistra to take me by the hand and welcome me into her hitherto forbidden domains. I was mistaken. I obtained the fabled book and took it into my study. As for what happened next...
Here. Place your hand over my heart. Let me show you.
You feel the tadpole quiver as you realize Gale is letting you in. Into the dark. You see through Gale's eyes, staring down the corridors of a dread memory. Bound and suddenly opened. Inside there are no creatures, only a swirling mass of blackest weave that pounces. Its teeth, its claws, it's unstoppable as it digs through and becomes part of you. And gods, is it ever hungry.
I'm sorry, but I had to. After all, this is only the beginning.
This Netherese blight, this orb, for lack of a better word, is balled up inside my chest, and it needs to be fed.
As long as I absorb traces of the weave from potent enough sources, it remains quiet. Were it ever to fully destabilize, however.
I will erupt.
I don't know the exact magnitude of the eruption, but given my studies of Netherese magic, I'd say even a fragment as small as the one I carry, it'd level a city the size of Waterdeep. I know.
All of this, it must feel like a betrayal. Say the word, and we'll part ways.
If having dangerous otherworldly objects stuck in your skin is wrong, then Gale and I both have to go. We're not really splitting up, are we?
That is a great relief. Oh, a great relief indeed. You truly are a soul that steals my own. From all my new rallied heart, I thank you. I thank you all. I understand if you stand against me. I'm humbled if you stand with me. Either way, I will do my best not to let you down. I stand at a precipice, but if you do not give up hope, neither shall I. I'll fight. I'll resist as long as I can. Now, even I am tired of the sound of my own voice. Let us venture forth.
don't fancy chasing this thing. It looks right mean.
Is it even?
Something over there.
No hope of clearing this without a shovel.
I'm talented!
Statue of Saluna. This room must have been dedicated to her. Now it's a nest for some filthy goblin. A fitting end.
Step carefully. There's a trap.
With a flick of the wrist.
What's next, I wonder?
Let's move.
Looks like the booze got the better of them. They're practically unconscious.
God's heck! My head hurts bad! Oh, rip your tongue!
As the symbol glows, power courses through you. Authority.
much talking. Jimmy on the go. I had a wild dream last night. This beautiful entity came to me, promised to protect me, told me the parasite in our heads could give us power. Sounds like it. What did you make of it? Damn right. Things like a splinter. We just need to find a way to squeeze it out.